Good day. This is going to be a little bit of a quick hit video on creating some architectural drawing shapes and then developing an elevation roof kind of orientation for the AutoCAD class. Ultimately, you want to start out by creating certain layers, you know, walls, elevation, roof, so that way you can work in the different orientation of things. You have already updated my units to be architectural units, and we can do point and shoot with the architectural units, so we'll do 10 feet vertical here, and then we'll do 10 feet horizontal, and we'll take both of these and change them over to the walls layer. From there, we'll do a zoom all or a zoom extents, either way, just so we can see the 10-foot distances. Now, typically, exterior walls are 6 inches and interior walls are 3.5 or 4 inches. You just kind of orient it around that environment. You can use the offset tool to accomplish that. So 6-inch offsets will offset the wall on the inside, so it's 6 inches from the outside, and then you can trim up the corner here to make it look appropriate. And if you decide to add an additional wall, let's say we specify a wall here, and we draw a wall in, you can then again do a offset, and this one being 4 inches to either side, and then trim it out. So that way the wall connection is done. Doors and windows are, again, another situation where we'll just go ahead and create this as another 10 foot and an offset of 6 foot. Excuse me, 6 inches. And that way. Now, when you got a corner like this, you can use a fillet with a radius 0 to take care of that. So fill it, my current radius is 0 down at the bottom, so I'll just pick the two entities and it'll clean up that corner for us. Interior doors, exterior doors are a different scenario, same thing, but what I'll do is I'll create a window here and we'll do a window. Windows and doors are basically the same for elevations, interior doors similarly also. So let's say we want to do an interior door, so I'll draw a vertical line where that door is going to be located. I'll then offset that line for an interior door, so we're going to offset this one 2 foot 6 inches, which is a typical bedroom size door. And so now we've got a 2 foot 6 inch door. Usually doors are not in the middle of the wall, however, you have to decide which way the door is going to open. So in this case, we'll set the door opening here. I'm going to go ahead and set this at about 135 degrees, which is a 45 degree angle. We know that the opening was 2 foot 6, so I'm going to draw my line 2 foot 6 inches. And what that allows us to do is to have this door now the same size as the opening. I can then trim the opening information, and the last thing is we create an arc. And to do the arc, what I like to do is, you can do a 3-point arc, but I like to do start in directions. That way I can pick the start point, the end point, and then I can work on the direction. And the direction is just vertical, so it's straight 90 degrees like that, and that gives us the door arc swing that we need to show how the door will open. The same situation for a window. So when I draw a line, I'll do a center line here for this window. And in windows, typically you have to have a certain size window that you're working with. And again, we're going to go ahead and offset it. So this particular window, we're going to offset 1 foot 6 inches. and so that'll offset to the right and to the left 1 foot six. That makes it 3 foot totally wide. And then for the window, to make it simple, all you have to do is draw a line from the midpoint of one of those vertical lines to the other midpoint. And so that window then gets placed in that location. Now what about elevations? So if we're going to create an elevation here, what I'd like to do is, and by the way, I drew most of this stuff not on the walls layer, so we'll go ahead and put this all on the walls layer here. And now we'll switch to the elevation layer. So when I start an elevation, what I'll do is I'll pick a point either below, to the left, or to the right, and I'll always draw it whatever the direction of the object is. So in this case, I'm going to draw below it. So I'm going to pick a point below it here, and I'm going to highlight. I'm not going to pick, I'm just going to highlight, and I'll get this green projection line. And I'll come down and I'll left mouse click and start a point. I'll then come over to the other end of the wall, and I'll again get a green projection line, and that intersection point is where I'll left mouse click again. So now that is the foundation or the base of my elevation. I'll then go ahead and draw an 8 foot tall wall, and not 8 inches, but 8 foot vertically. And I'll come back and I'll highlight and again project over and left mouse click and left mouse click. And so this now represents that 10 foot wall that I created. But now we've got to put a window in. And so with the windows, the easiest way to accomplish that is to offset from the bottom where you started, 6 foot 8. So windows and doors typically have a height of 6 foot 8, and that's the top. Now the vertical part of the window is going to be, or the vertical styles of the window will then be projected down. Again, highlight when you get to the intersection of that offset line, left mouse click. And typically, windows are 4 or 5 feet tall. The key is make sure that you're vertical when you begin typing, or else your window is not going to be accurate. So we'll go 5 foot. And I'll do the same thing on the other side. Highlight the corner of the window, bring it straight down to the intersection, left mouse click, and now that I have the 5 foot distance, I can highlight and bring across that connection point. So now I've got the makings of this window shape with this. And so we'll trim the extra lines off. And now we've got a window with an elevation. When you're doing elevations, you know, you can do clapboards where you can offset the bottom row or the bottom line 6 inches, and then you can make like wooden clapboards as a siding. You could also apply the option of hatch patterns. And so you can go to hatch pattern, and they actually have hatch patterns that focus on architectural brick. So the AR hatch patterns are architectural brick and block styles. So this one, ARBR standard, is a standard brick size. 8x16 are concrete blocks, and this is 8x16 with a mortar joint in between. So we'll do ARBR standard. And one of the interesting things is that we can do a hatch pattern, and the hatch pattern, you know, we can just highlight it, click it, hit OK. But here's one of the key components. Let me zoom in. If you zoom in on the very bottom, how many times do they start with just a brick that's just a partial brick on the bottom? So let's go ahead and I'll actually do this. So let's go ahead and put the hatch pattern in. Let me zoom out, have the hatch pattern appear. I'll select it. How many times do we start with a quarter brick and a half brick on the end of the corner. That's not really common. So the way you can get around that is by setting the origin point. So if you pick a new origin point, which is like the lower left-hand corner, look what happens to the brick. The brick resets itself, so now you've got a whole brick starting at the bottom of your elevation. It just looks better. And then you can go ahead and accept and close the hatch pad, the hatch creation. And now you've got a hatched wall. Creating the elevation, or creating the roof plan, not overly difficult. The big thing is you need to know what your roof pitch is. And roof pitches are typically ranging from 312 in the Midwestern region. 412 is the minimum because of snow. And as you move farther south, the roof pitches get steeper because the hot air needs to rise farther away from the living area. So 812, 1012, 1212, which is a 45 degree angle, are not uncommon in a lot of areas. So creating this roof pitch, so let's swap over to our roof layer, and we'll start this process by drawing a line in the midpoint of the elevation. So we're going to find the midpoint of the elevation, we're going to draw a line straight up. Okay, so all it is that just helps us find the midpoint. Alright, so now the way that elevations go is, as we said, roof pitch is like 4 by 12. Well, what does that mean? That means for every 12 inches horizontally, it goes up 4 inches. Oh, well, that's interesting. And that's easy to draw. So we can start at the corner of the house, draw over or horizontally 12 inches, we just type in 12, and then we come up 4 or 5 inches, so if we do a 5 or a 4 or 6, 4 or 6 12 pitch roof, it's very easy just to type in 4 or 6. We'll do a 4 12 pitch roof. This will be a pretty low roof. So we'll do a 4 inch. And so now I've got an angle. So I've got a hypotenuse that I can now draw between the start point and the 12-4 pitch. While using the extend command that's found under trim, I can extend this line to the midpoint line. Wow, there's half my roof. I can also then use the mirror command and mirror it to the other side. So I can pick mirror, select the line, right mouse click, and then just pick two points on the midpoint, and it'll ask me, do I want to erase the source objects? No. And now I've got the same roof pitch on both sides. I can clean this up a little bit by deleting the two roof lines, my original 412. And now to clean up the roof, basically I'm just going to offset for an eave and locate an eave setting. And so fascia boards on the roof are usually 5.5 inches, so we'll offset 6 inches. So we'll just offset 6 inches, and we'll take the offset on both of these 6 inches up, and then we're going to draw a line 1 foot out. Because right now, a lot of the eaves that you're working with at homes are 12 inches. And so that 12-inch location away from the house, and I'll just draw a vertical line here, just so I have a construction line creation. And I'm going to do this on both sides. Now, could I mirror this to the other side? Absolutely. I could pick mirror, pick this line, pick the vertical line in the center, and do not erase source objects. So now we're getting pretty close to creating our roof. We can extend our fascia boards out that to that extra foot on each side, and then I can extend the lines also to the roof peak. Now it's a series of trims and some cleanup, and we're all set. So we'll just go back to trim, clean up the extra lines on the outside, erase the center line, and if I want clapboards, I can then just use an offset. I can draw a line and then just use an offset of that line every 6 inches. And I've got 6-inch offset already set. So I can just pick this object and offset it up, pick the object, offset it up, pick the object, offset it up, and then just use the trim tool and just trim this back. And clean it up. So we're not looking for a set of house plans in this particular project. What we're looking for is the ability to visualize from a floor plan to an elevation is the idea. And the structure is simple overall. So this will get you to that particular level. If you really wanted to clean it up, you could draw and have a return and again trim out the bottom if you wanted to have a clean return on your fascia where your soffit is consistent, and then just trim this back, and now you've got a very clean soffit here compared to a little bit less of a clean overhang area. So that's it. That's the idea. That should get you started in on this project. Again, start with the floor plan, project to the elevation, and then create the roof based on the roof pitch. Have a great day. We'll talk to you soon.